Hey guys, I'm Ben from Authentech and I love my Mavic. It's ultra small and portable, convenient for tossing in a bag and carrying around, yet I'm not compromising on camera quality. It still captures me 4K video that's smooth and stable with its 3-axis gimbal. The dedicated controller gives me fast sport mode, ultra precision in the sticks, and more than far enough control distance. Plus, its price is pretty crazy affordable for all the features you get. Now, I also love my Phantom 4 Advance Plus. It has the built-in bright video screen on the controller. It's super quick to grab, get in the air, and start shooting right away. Plus, the wide-angle 1-inch camera sensor helps me capture amazing aerial cinematic shots. 20-megapixel still photos, 4K 60fps video footage at 100 megabits per second bitrate. Now, I often read in the comments people who are split between the Mavic and Phantom series. And even though there's a bit of a price difference, I'll compare on those later, it's not exactly apples to apples. I think it's still very interesting if we compare photo and video footage side by side, see the differences and maybe even the similarities in shots, see which one you guys like better. Now, starting off with some bright outdoor daytime photos, I shot in highest resolution default settings on both. There's a lot of fun things to notice. The color saturation seems a bit punchier on the Mavic, while the Phantom has that more realistic color profile. Dynamic range looks good on both, but I'd have to give it to the Phantom with slightly more details left in the shadows and highlights. The sharpness and clarity is fantastic on both. Seriously, the Mavic images look really nice. But when you side-by-side compare them, that Mavic sensor is just 12 megapixels, and while that's still really good, while a Phantom is packing a crazy 1-inch 20 megapixel sensor. When we zoom way in, you can really spot the differences and see the impressive sensor of the Phantom. Another key difference on both, the Mavic has a field of view of 78.8 degrees, versus the Phantom has a bit wider angle, 84 degree field of view. And 35mm format equivalent, that's a 28mm f2.2 on the Mavic and a 24mm f2.8 on the Phantom. Now, I also did a quick near focus test, and again, the common theme I'm finding, that Mavic looks really good, but the Phantom is just a tad bit better with color, clarity, sharpness, and resolution. One interesting difference, since the Mavic has that lower f-stop, it can actually have a bit more blurred out background when focused close, versus the Phantom has a bit less of that shallow depth of field. Now, honestly, I'm not sure if you really want crazy shallow depth of field when capturing aerial shots, but whichever way you lean, you can keep this in mind. Now, let's switch to some video comparisons, and again, shooting both in default settings. The Mavic tops out at 4K 30fps and a max bitrate of 60 megabits per second, while the Phantom peaks at a crazy 4K 60fps, 100 megabits per second. Now, here's some of the things I noticed. The same color contrast and saturation punch on the Mavic is still here, and that Phantom maintains more the natural looking image. The Mavic looks sharp, possibly just a tinge over-sharpened, depending on your personal preference, while the Phantom just looks sharp with high clarity and not too much over-processing going on. Honestly though, make sure you're watching this video in 4K if you can, because I was super impressed with how good both of these cameras performed. The 3-axis gimbal stabilization is rock solid and smooth on both. Again, you should notice the Phantom has a little wider angle field of view, which I prefer. I like to squeeze more of the landscapes and whatever subjects I'm filming into the frame. Now, here's some low light photo and video test shots. Differences to look for is how's exposure and color balance. What about noise and grain in the image? With that larger 1-inch sensor on the Phantom, this is an area it will strongly outshine some of the competition with smaller sensors. Thankfully, the lower f-stop on the Mavic helps it out in this area for low light testing. Both drones offer amazing flying distance, both rated up to 4.3 miles or 7 kilometer max transmission range. Now, they both have all the smart video tracking and flight safety features like return to home and front object avoidance sensors. Max speed in sports mode is 40 miles per hour on the Mavic, 45 on the Phantom. Battery life is similar too, up to 27 minutes on the Mavic and 30 minutes on the Phantom. And last up is another big deciding factor. How does pricing compare? Well, prices are always adjusting, so be sure you're checking out the current pricing links I'll give you down below. As of today, in August 2017, the Mavic base package is $1,000, and this Phantom 4 Advanced Plus model with this built-in screen is $500 more at $1,500. Honestly, I use them both all the time. I love the small portability of the Mavic and those punchy, tighter shots it produces, but the Phantom Plus has that convenient built-in screen, 1-inch sensor, and 60 FPS 4K video footage that just looks stellar. Now, I just posted my full review of the Phantom 4 Advanced Plus model. Make sure you check that video out as well. Which drone and camera do you guys like better? Let me know which one and why down in the comments. I'm always reading your comments and trying to respond when I can. Oh, and make sure you're subscribed for more drone videos that I post like this all the time. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, let's live authentic.